When we go out and study earthquakes, fundamentally there are three things that we can learn about them. We look at where the earthquakes happen, we look at how frequently they recur in time, because they're parts of ongoing tectonic processes. They repeat over time in slightly different ways, slightly different natures, but always in the same place, steadily over and over. And then we understand, and then we seek to understand how large these earthquakes were and how large potential future earthquakes could be, so that we understand how what a population will be exposed to. These three pieces of information, where earthquakes happen, how often they recur, and how large they are when they do repeat, all inform our preparation for the eventuality of earthquakes. Understanding where they happen allows governments to establish building codes and know where you need buildings that have to be resilient to particular earthquakes, where you're at risk of other impacts like ground failures and other things that happen during the shaking of earthquakes. Understanding how often earthquakes happen in a given place allows a society to adjust economically to accommodate the eventual impacts of an earthquake when it does happen. And, of course, understanding the size of a potential earthquake allows people and governments and agencies to anticipate the impacts of those particular events, to understand the strength of ground motions and shaking that people, resources, everything around them are exposed to. The Earth system is large and operates at a big scale. Knowing precisely when an earthquake will happen, down to the seconds and minutes, maybe even hours that people want, is impossible. What we can do is understand how frequently earthquakes recur, and to understand the interval it's been since the last one. This is where what we do as earth scientists comes in, because the historic record of earthquakes is often not long enough. Oral written records, even oral records, don't extend over multiple earthquake cycles in a particular place. And so we go back and we look at the record of these in the landscape. My research on earthquakes has taken me around the planet, looking at events that happened as recently as a week prior to earthquakes that happened centuries or even millennia ago. So you can see here that just last night there was a magnitude 6.8 earthquake north of the UK up in the Arctic Ocean. Seismometers around the world recorded it, and so you can see here from miles, thousands of miles away, the seismic waves traveled for an earthquake this large. These are three different components of motion for each station. So this is one station, the eastward motion, the northward motion, and the vertical motion. And so together that records the full three-dimensional motion of the ground. So many earth scientists are involved in the research and understanding of these natural phenomena, earthquakes, volcanoes, the atmosphere, floods, natural phenomena that impact societies. There's a huge field of research, academic research at universities, at institutions, government agencies, non-government organizations are all involved in trying to understand these natural geological processes. Earth sciences also underpin a great deal of what surrounds us in society. The materials that make up our buildings, our cars, the devices that you're watching this video on, those all come from mineral resources. And so an additional entire field of our sciences is in mineral exploration, resource exploration. Like it or not, we have to find these things to operate modern society. Earth scientists are also at the forefront of developing renewable technologies as well. Hydropower, wind power, these things all involve Earth and environmental scientists. In all of this, the most interesting thing to me is consistently the snapshot of active tectonics, that these forces that over millions of years build mountains and shape the landscapes around us, you can see the increments of change that happen in just a matter of seconds of violent shaking and tumult. And the record of that, this little snapshot of how tectonic forces and the large-scale geology intersects with human timescales, is always what really fascinates me and captivates me about earthquakes.